The death toll due to Typhoon Naghon in Quezon Province climbs to 6. Local police said the 2 new fatalities died in Lucena City, while the other drowned in Mauban. The country's disaster management agency earlier reported another death, a teenager who was crushed by a toppled tree in Misamis Oriental. The Agriculture Department said initial damage by the typhoon to crops is at 11.8 million pesos. Prior to leaving for Brunei, President Marcos assured typhoon-ravaged areas, help is on the way.
Kagaya ng dati, lahat ng aming ginagawa in coordination, siyempre ang first responder lagi dyan, ang ating mga LGU. Kaya't as usual, they have brought all their energies together at the very first instance. At nasabayan naman, nasundan kaagad ng national government sa pamamagitan ng pagbigay ng assistance, pagbigay ng rescue, search and rescue na ginawa. Hindi natin titigilan ito, siyempre, hanggang matapos ang ating pagtulong sa mga nasalanta, sa mga naging biktima dito sa ating mga area na tinamaan ng agon.
A Philippine House lawmaker slamming China's fishing ban in parts of the West Philippine Sea, as well as its order to the Chinese Coast Guard to arrest foreign trespassers beginning June 15. Zambales 1st District Representative Jay Kong Hoon rejects Beijing's claim that its fishing ban is meant to preserve marine life. He asserts China is actually the one behind the environmental degradation in the disputed territory. Kong Hoon also calling on the Coast Guard and the military to protect Filipino fisherfolk.
Siyempre, natatakot tayo para sa kanila dahil ito'y totoong buhay na. No? Talagang kanilang kabuhayan yung nakasalalay dito. Yan ang ginagamit nila upang pakainin yung kanilang pamilya, bigyan ng magandang kinabukasan yung kanilang mga anak. At talagang sana nananawagan tayo sa ating Philippine Coast Guard, ating mga kundaluhan, na protektahan sana yung ating mangingisda, lalong-lalo na dumalaot sa West Philippine Sea.
Congressman Kong Hoon also questioned the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources' use of its funds. He says the BFAR should do more for local fishermen other than donating small, manually powered boats. A group of fishermen in the West Philippine Sea unfazed by China's fishing ban, according to Leonardo Quaresma, president of the new Masinloc Fishermen Association. This is just one of the many threats they face every day. He also tells the Philippine government instead of sending aid, which only lasts a couple of days, the government should walk the talk and actually do security patrols in the disputed waters.
Kung sila ay tutulong sa amin, kailangan namin yung matatag na hanap buhay ng bawat sambayanan nating mga Pilipinong nangingisda. At hindi yung pansamantala lang na pangangailangan. Tingin ko po ay paigtingin yung kanilang pagpapatrulya sa ating pong karagatan sapagkat sinasabi nila na madalas na tuwing may pumapalawak daw ng mga mangingisda ay ni-escortan ito ng mga Coast Guard natin, nandiyan daw yung ating mga Navy, nandiyan daw yung mga BFAR. Pero ang totoo niyan, mula po nung nagkaroon ng suliranin sa ating karagatan sa West Philippine Sea, mula po nung pumapalawak kami, wala pa naman kaming nakita na in-escortan na isa man sa ating pong mga mangingisda.
Denise Insay now joins us with a story from the Banco Central and the latest corporate news. Hi, Denise.
Hi, Stanley. An external survey by the Philippine Central Bank shows analysts expect its monetary easing to last until 2026. The BSP's monetary policy report this month found watchers project a quarter point cut by the end of the year. They expect the benchmark rate to be slashed by another 25 basis points for 2025 and ultimately by 50 the year after that. The moves would bring the BSP's key rate, which is currently at a near 17-year high of 6.5%, to 5.5. This is, of course, contingent with inflation expectations of 3.7% by the year end. Analysts see the measure of consumer prices settling at 3.5% both in 2025 and in 2026. Some corporate stories: Alternergy secures an 8 billion peso loan from banks. The borrowing from BPI and Security Bank is to help fund the construction of its wind project in Tanay, Rizal. The project is targeted to be completed by next year. Meanwhile, Bloomberg Resorts dismisses as mere speculations a report that said it is eyeing to expand operations to Thailand. The operator of the Solaire Resort and Casino, and recently of Solaire North, told the local bourse there is no such plan. It responded to query from an online report which said Bloom is monitoring Thailand's efforts to legalize casinos for a boost in revenues.